best books ever written by man, but inspired by God. Y'all ready? The 13th chapter. The Spirit told me to do this one. 13th chapter. On the same day, Jesus went out of the house and sat by the sea.
All right.
And a great multitude were gathered together to him, so that he got into a boat and sat. And the whole multitude stood on the shore. Then he spake many things to them in parables, saying, Behold, a sower went out to sow.
All right.
And as he sowed, some seeds fell by the wayside, and the birds came and devoured them. Some fell on the fifth verse, some fell on stony places where they did not have much earth. And they immediately sprang up because they had no depth of earth. The sixth verse says, But when the sun was up, they were scorched. And because they had no root, they withered away. And the seventh verse says, And some fell among thorns, and the thorns sprang up and choked them. The eighth verse says, Others fell on good ground and yielded a crop. Some 100-fold, some 60, some 30. But that ninth verse is very important. It said, He who has ears. Ears.
Yeah.
It didn't say ear. Oh, we got two of them.
Yeah.
He said, He who has ears.
Let him hear.
He who have ears, let them hear. Now we don't break down that first to the eighth, but that ninth verse is very important. You can have the sixth. The ninth verse is very important. The ninth verse says, He who has ears, let them hear. So if you're deaf and you can't hear me, then I need to get somebody to do some sign language because you need to hear. I'm talking about he's forceful with this. He said, Let him who has ears hear this, what I'm saying. Now, the Bible describes Jesus' parables as stories. We know what a parable is, right? First of all, listen to me. When Jesus told a parable, it was because he wanted to make people of simple means, of simple minds, understand what he was really, actually, and truly talking about. Now, when my mama used to try to make a little sense to me, when she knew if she said it in one way, it would go over my head, or if she said it, mama used to say, now Kevin, listen at me good. She would say it like that, so when I did mess up, it was no mistake in why she was taking that belt and wearing it across my butt. She wanted me to understand what she was really, really trying to say. So Jesus, in the same fashion, he's trying to get us to understand that I'm trying to tell you it's two places in the end time, heaven or hell. He's trying to get you to understand that. So he says, in his first one, he says, on that fourth one, he says, a sower went out, and the sower ain't nobody but you and me. You and me. We're the sowers. He said, went out. And he was sowing some seeds. And the seeds fell by the wayside. And the birds came and devoured them. Now this first type of seed which falls on the hardened path is immediately eaten by birds. What is the bird? Do anybody know what a bird is? Okay, here the bird is symbolized as the devil. The bird ain't nothing but the devil. He said here, right here, that immediately these seeds was eaten up by birds. And it corresponds to those who have a hard heart towards God. This is what this verse is talking about. Somebody that have a hardened heart towards God. And when they hear the word of God, they are unreceptive to the word of God, and the truth hurts them. When the truth is turned around, when the word of God is turned around, then it bothers them. So Jesus said that they proved keeps on by the wayside. What is the wayside? The wayside is some unuseful, no producing, no good, good for nothing. You know, the Bible says that salt, when it loses its savor, that is good for nothing but to be trodden under the feet of men. And we are the salt of the earth. That means that we ought to be a little bit. I'm talking about when we're going forth with the word of God, said, when we're in the word of God, then it ought to be some folks that's in your life and some stuff in your life that can't handle you.
Come on now.
You ever turned up? I did it before when I was little, but I ain't did it no more. Took a box of salt and turned it up and threw up everywhere.
Right.
Folks ought to see you and start throwing up.
Throw it up
because you're the word of God. You are the salt of the earth. I mean, Jesus left us here, said, so that we may plant some seeds and go forth in his word. He said, in this first one, in the fourth verse, he said, the first type of seed which falls is a person that has a hardened heart towards God. What kind of person are you?
All right.
To have a hardened heart towards God. And then he uses a bird, and he don't disguise it. He said, this symbolizes the devil. Just as much as you sit in church, as many times as you come to church and you get the word of God and you learn the word of God, you read the word of God. I'm talking about you walking like you know the word of God. You in your house singing like you got the word of God. But it looked like every time you plant seeds, you're not watching where you're planting.
All right.
Children of God, brothers and sisters, little girls and little boys, I don't care where you are, who you are, what you got, you gotta watch. The Bible says, stay prayerful and watchful. Now, it would just tell you to stay prayerful if you didn't need to know where your seeds was going. Now, by the wayside can't help you. By the wayside can't help, can't bless you. See, he said, this man, this farmer, threw his seeds by the wayside. And all the birds kept doing was coming down. Every time he would go in the house, the bird would come down, and they would eat up all the seeds. And then he came out in the morning shocked.
All right.
What you shocked for?
Come on now.
You ever walk past somebody's lawn, and they got more seeds on the sidewalk than they got in the grass?
All right.
And you be standing like, that ain't gonna work.
No.
People of God, this is what Jesus said. Stop throwing your seed. And then we wondering why. I'm talking about, see, we got folks, Mother Mo. We over in somebody else's yard pulling up daisies when we ought to be in our own yard pulling up the weed. That's the reason. And I said that this morning, I'm gonna say it again. We ought to stop pulling up daisies and start pulling up these weeds because maybe our kids will stop smoking them. Maybe we'll stop smoking them if we get them about their yard. I mean, we plant our seeds. We plant our seeds on the wayside. That can get you blessed. Jesus said that you need to throw your seeds on good ground.
All right.
You wonder why our finances messed up. The birds, you see.
Come on,
right,
come on.
Every time you throw something out there for God to bless you, the devil come and pick it up, scoop it up, and go on about his business, and he laughing at you. You know, when you sitting there talking about, man, I ain't getting that church on my money, the devil just planted the thing. He took that seed from God saying that this whole nation has robbed me and that you need to give me a dime out of every dollar. The devil went and scooped it up and said, you ain't got to give him nothing. So the devil is taking all of your blessings.
Come on,
Reverend. You're taking all your blessings. I mean, how long? How long is it going to be before we recognize and realize that every seed we plant, we need to guard it?
All right.
We need to guard it. And see, we plant seeds, and then we don't care where they're growing.
All right.
We don't care where they're growing. Kenny, I'm talking about, why would I be in a bar planting seeds?
Right.
Huh?
Wow.
I don't party no more. Why would I be in a tavern planting seeds?
Why?
Huh? See, first of all, that's where the devil gonna pick them up at, and you ain't gonna get no blessing for it no way. But Unless you plant some seeds. Plant some seeds at home. You know what's wrong with our children right now? There ain't no seeds planted. Let me show you how you plant seeds at home. At 8 o'clock in the morning while you getting dressed for church, everybody getting dressed for church. At 8:30, Johnny shouldn't be sitting in front of the TV talking about some, I'll see you later, mama. You ain't playing. You threw him up by the wayside. Because he's still sitting there in his little drawers and his little tank top, and he's playing PlayStation, and you walking out the door. You didn't plant no seed. Now, let me reverse the situation. If you would have planted a seed, what would have happened was, cut the light out, and we're going on. And, matter of fact, don't get in the car. You sit in the back seat this morning, Johnny. I don't want the police to stop me, and y'all would have been driving down the street. See, that's planting a seed. And see, when you plant seeds like that, then when you pass on, he'll plant a seed. And if he plant the seed, then another seed will be planted. And then that's how God wants it. He wants you to plant seeds at home. He wants you to plant. I'm talking about if your husband not saved, sooner or later, where do y'all go? You don't follow him or he don't follow you. But you plant that seed of him watching you. Read the Bible on every day. I'm talking about you plant that seed with no cussing and fussing. And I'm talking about you're cussing fuss by yourself. But sooner or later, all right. If you plant the seed, it'll grow. Sooner or later, Jesus said right here, he said, this type of seed, the devil takes away from you.
Yeah.
Get tired. You need to be sick and tired of being tired. Of you trying your best. And no, you got no, I'm talking about it's no type of, I'm talking about you ain't got no production. You ain't got, I'm talking about you don't see nothing coming from it. You don't see nothing produced from it. The Bible says that if you don't have, if you're not producing, what does Jesus need with you? Yeah. You remember he killed that plant? He killed that plant. He said, what good is it to me? Listen, what good is your children if you're not going to plant the seed that was planted in you?
Yeah. All right.
You know what I mean? When you see them standing on the corner with their pants down and turning up or cheating, oh, y'all know what that means?
Yeah.
Okay. Listen. Cheating.
Yeah.
Ain't no seed been planted. Ain't no seed been planted. Ain't no seed. Matter of fact, if the seeds was planted, you gotta care about where your seeds are being thrown.
All right.
In some places, you ought not want to see no blessings in. I don't want to see no blessings in crime. I don't want to see them. See, you can throw in some seeds out there that we need to stumble. There's some seeds out there that we need to brush back over in the yard and try to make them grow right. Listen, Jesus said these seeds right here. In that third, in that fourth verse, it says, them seeds takes the truth away. And what does the devil do? He's a liar. He's the father of a liar. Now listen to this next verse. He said, some fell on stony places where they did not have much earth.
All right.
And they immediately sprang up because they had no depth of earth. Mm-hmm. The second type of seed, which falls on rocky soil, corresponds to those who initially respond positively to God's word, but when the truth starts to hurt, they abandon the word of God there in person. You know what Jesus was talking about right there? He was talking about you. I'm talking about we look like we're saved, we act like we're saved, we run around and we're so holy. And I can always tell you, Mother Mo, you need to do this. I can always tell you, my house, as far as me and my house, this is what's going to happen. Jesus said, this guy right here, he was just like the Pharisees. And that's what they call them Pharisees, because they were throwing them Pharisees. And listen, he said, they're just like the Pharisees. They were over there talking about telling Jesus, you know, your disciples, they don't obey the law. They're supposed to wash their hands before they eat dinner. Jesus says, it's more lawful to wash your hands or to obey God. They were just like these Pharisees. Jesus said, this guy was throwing seeds around everybody else's house.
Come on now, brother.
He was throwing seeds around everybody else's house.
All right.
I'm talking about it being yellow there with yellow grass. you don't need to be running around here making my grass greener, and you got to